السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How many of you here lost 10 pounds so far? Anybody? 10 10 10 تكبير. All right. الحمد لله. So inshallah if you lose 10 pounds or more come at the end of Ramadan to the office inshallah. I'm serious. Inshallah we'll have something nice for you. Don't ask me what it is. I'll keep it as a surprise. All right? Huh? I will have the scale. No, I'll take your word for it. Inshallah, I have two things. Khatira of tonight. And then inshallah, we will have an opportunity to share the khair, inshallah. Share the khair. It rhymes, right? English, Arabic. Share the khair. Inshallah, we'll do that, inshallah. Because we as Muslims, we share. And we have lots of khair. Mu'min always have khair around him, inshallah. May Allah make khair between us and among us and above us and from us, inshallah, Rabbul Alameen. And give us an opportunity to share it. Tonight's hero, among those who were around Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was known by his title. And his name was not known, even to many of the tabi'een. He had two sons, Muhammad and Abdul Rahman. And they narrated from him. They are from the tabi'een. And also Hassan al-Basri narrated from him. And there is another tabi'i, his name is Sa'id ibn Jamhan. He narrated this hadith that I'm going to share with you right now. He said that I went to this sahabi and I stayed with him 8 days to do nothing but ask him about the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he told him, tell me the story of your title. What is your name? He told him, ما أنا بمخبرك. I'm not going to tell you my name. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called me Safina. Rasulullah called me Safina. Safina means ship. So his name or his title that Rasulullah called him was what? Ship. Safina. Mawla Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mawla, يعني freed slave. He was the slave of Umm Salamah radiallahu anha. She freed him with one condition. She said that you continue serving Rasulullah for the rest of your life. He said, I accept. So she freed him and he became the Mawla of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why he is called Safina? Sa'id ibn Jamhan asked him. He told him, one time I was with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَثَقُلَ عَلَيْهِمْ مَتَاعُهُمْ يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم and his companions, they were carrying their gear and it was kind of a little bit heavy for them. So he said, أُبْسُطْ كِسَاءَكْ. You know, he has like a mantle around him or a cover or a comforter or something. He said, put it on the ground. He said, I put it in the ground and Rasulullah put his stuff and ordered everybody with him to put his stuff. And he told him, fold it. Fold it, he said, carry it. He said, I carry it like a feather. He said, فَلَوْ حَمَلْتُ حِمْلَ بَعِيرٍ أَوْ اثْنَيْنِ أَوْ ثَلَاثَ أَوْ أَرْبَعَ أَوْ خَمْسَ أَوْ سِتَّةَ لَا أَشْعُرْ. He said, even if I carry the weight of one camel, two, three, four, five, six, I will never feel it. Because Rasulullah told me to do that. صلى الله عليه وسلم. So this was the companion of Rasulullah. They said his name is Mahran, Ruman, Qais, different names. But what we know him by the name is Safina. The Mawla of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is another narration for him. He said, when I accepted the Islam and you know became a slave and all that, he said, one time I was after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, I was traveling in a small ship and then you know it's broken, shipwreck. And then he said, I went out in a small place and there was a lion coming to attack us. So I told him, Ana Safina, Mawla Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I am Safina, the freed slave of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said that the lion passed, left us, subhanallah, with the barakah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And all of these narrations, they are sahih there. So may Allah gather us with Safina, Mawla Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Jannatul Na'im, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. And I hope you enjoyed the story of tonight. Can we share the khair, inshallah? Inshallah, we have the Baytul Mal that assigned to this masjid. This masjid assigned to collect the zakah money. So we're collecting zakah money. We did a great job, alhamdulillah, last year. And inshallah, we'll do a better job this year, inshallah. Say inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. And the Islamic Society of Greater Houston, they give certain relief organizations the opportunity to use the Islamic centers to collect for their cause. But it is 50-50. So the local needy, IGH will take care of, and the relief organization will take care of the global needy as well. So alhamdulillah, this is a very beautiful agreement that we do not compromise any. And we as Muslims feel that our money is helping our Muslim brothers and sisters everywhere. Around us, Islamic Society of Greater Houston will do it, and the Baytul Mal that signed to this masjid, inshallah, will do globally as well. So alhamdulillah, you feel at peace that your money for the zakah went and helped everyone around you without having that struggle whether I give locally or not. So inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, we would love all of us, inshallah, to give from our zakah money today, or give all your zakah money or part of it, alhamdulillah, whatever, it's your discretion. And Brother Faiz is here, and there's a booth outside. So inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, na'am? Yes, there are envelopes as well. And please, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, you know, try to help as much as you can. Last year, we did a donation. So inshallah, if by show of hand, I just need to see the commitment. But just that's the commitments, inshallah. By show of hand, inshallah, if you are going to give from your zakah money tonight, inshallah. But just by show of hand, inshallah. MashaAllah, almost half of that. MashaAllah, MashaAllah. So please give from your zakah money, inshallah. I don't want to make it a traditional fundraising. I wish, I'm itching to do it, but I was told to keep it like that. So alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, inshallah, our masjid will show a great example to help our brothers. These organizations, my brothers and sisters, is that they're making something on our behalf that it becomes necessary in our time now. It is very hard for you and me to know or to decide how and where to give the zakah. And when you find an organization, they become the wakil, remember this word, they become the wakil of both. They become the wakil of both parties. The wakil of the ghani who gives, and the wakil of the poor who receives. So once the zakah is deposited today, is accepted, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. All right? Once the zakah. So they accept it, they take it from you, means the target is the organization that you give it to. Now delivery is their responsibility, because also they receive it on behalf of somebody who is in need. So they have double responsibility in front of Allah Azza wa Jal to take that money from the one who gave it, accept it from you, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, responsibility on them to deliver it. And they received it on behalf of the needy, and that needy, inshallah, will receive it from them, bi'idhnillah ta'ala. So can we do that, inshallah, tonight, inshallah? We'll just, na'am, na'am. Allahu Akbar.
We had this program last year, the zakah more than doubled. We collected about $180,000 from this masjid last year. Now, of course, we gave the need in Houston $1.32 million last year for the local need.
Alhamdulillah.
For the sadaqah, we gave $2,002,000.
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. So the numbers here from our IGH treasure said from this masjid alone in 2016, $86,000 were collected for the whole year for the zakah money only from this masjid. Say takbir. Oh. Alhamdulillah. Last year, the money doubled. There was about $180,000 from this masjid only. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, in zakah. Say takbir, Alhamdulillah. Oh. And we hope it doubles this year, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Oh. Ya Rab. And locally, 1.32 million dollars were delivered in Houston for the local needy people from the zakah money, and the $2 million, including the sadaqah, were done. So alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, say alhamdulillah, and may Allah make us that cause, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. So please, from your zakah and from your sadaqah as well, the money, alhamdulillah, they figured out the system, they will have it. It will be deposited as soon as possible and delivered as soon as possible, inshallah, in the month of Ramadan, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Anything, Brother Nader? I'm free to go? All right. Jazakumullah khairan. Pray soon, inshallah. Thank you.